Hello everyone, I'm Linda Colmenares and I'll be sharing today's daily devotion. Today I want to open up in Psalms 91:2 that says, "The heavens declare the glory of God, the skies proclaim the works of His hands. Day after day they pour forth speech, night after night they reveal the knowledge of Him." If I were to say these names, President Joe Biden, the Queen Elizabeth, or Bill Gates, you would naturally think of people at high status or high power or lots of wealth. Because of the positions in society, we easily know a lot of information about them, such as their birthdays, their favorite colors, their favorite foods. But just because we can name the names of their children or know their birthdays, it doesn't mean we actually know them. We just know about them. And if we're not careful, we tend to do the same thing with God. We tend to know about God, but we don't know Him personally. And that's not what we want to do. God wants us to know Him. That's why Psalms 91:1-2 says that the creation reveals knowledge of Him. Through creation, we can see all kinds of things. We can see that He's a God of abundance. He created the trees. He didn't need to create all the different types of trees we have. With one tree, it could have been enough. But we learn from creation that He's a God of abundance. That's just one example. So that's why it's important that we know Him. That's right. God wants us to know Him. The same God who created the heavens and the earth, the same God who knows the numbers of the hair on your head, He wants you to know Him personally. And that's why Jesus came to this earth, so that there would be no barriers between us and Him. You can know God. Hebrews 8:11 says, "No longer will they teach their neighbor or say to one another, 'Know the Lord,' because they will know me from the least of them to the greatest of them." See, you don't even need to have a high status or lots of power. God wants to know you for you, and He wants you to know Him. He wants you to know His heart. He wants you to know His joy and even His plans. God wants you to know Him. So what are the steps to knowing God? How can we know God easily? Hosea 6:3 says, "Oh, that we might know the Lord. Let us press on to know Him. He will respond to us as surely as the arrival of the dawn or the coming of the rains in early springs." God wants us to seek Him. It doesn't just happen from one day to the next. We have to work at it. And these are a few simple steps you can do in your pursuit of God. The first thing is the simplest one. Seek the Word of God. Maybe you don't know a lot about God's love. There's lots of apps out there. There's Google that can direct you to verses specifically on God's love. That's just one example. Whatever it is that you want to know about God, look it up. Find the verses. The second thing is, come to Him in prayer. Ask God. Have a simple conversation with God. Prayer does not have to be complicated. It doesn't have to be an hour long. It can be as simple as, "God, today I need your help." Simply by acknowledging Him, we get to see Him reveal Himself to us in our everyday life. And the third thing is, be a worshiper. You know, I'm a worshiper every day of my life. Now, that doesn't mean I'm singing worship songs every day. But when I worship God for the things that I can recognize in my life. For example, I recognize that God provides for me. So I worship Him for that reason. It's not a long song, but I give God thanks. I'm grateful. And the reason why we do these three simple steps is because it renews our mind. Paul tells us to not be transformed, do not follow the patterns of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind. And when we renew our mind, we can see God at work in our lives. We no longer see the pattern of the world, but instead we begin to see what God is doing in our lives from the very beginning, simply by going into the Word, praying, and being a worshiper every day of your life. God wants you to know Him. He's not so big and powerful that He doesn't want to know us. He's so big and powerful that He loves us so much. He wants us to know Him at that level. Today, I would like to encourage you to seek God. Maybe, perhaps, all three steps is too complicated for you. Start with one step and watch God reveal Himself to you in these areas. This day, I'll just offer a simple prayer that the Lord will reveal Himself to you as you draw near to Him in the name of Jesus. God, we are so thankful for Your Word. Your Word describes to us, God, that even in creation, Lord, You reveal Your glory to us, God, that we cannot deny who You are. You are a living God who wants us to know Him, to know You, Lord. And that's what we purpose this day, Lord. We purpose, God, in our hearts, Father, to seek You, Lord. You said that You will reveal Yourself to us, God, and this day, Lord, we pray that You begin Your divine revelation in the areas that we need to understand Your ways and not our ways, Father God. That we would begin to renew our minds with Your character, Your love, and Your joy, Lord, and Your passion, Father God. That we would begin to seek You, Lord, and nothing else. In the name of Jesus, amen. Hello, everyone. Well, thank you for joining us today for our daily devotion. As always, we are so glad you have joined us. If you have a prayer request, feel free to send it over. We have a pastoral staff, people who here who just love to pray and intercede on your behalf. We would love to do that as well. Always remember that we are here live at 10 a.m. and are showing our live service on YouTube. As always, share, like, and comment. Yeah.